I put a tire on the front wheel. Getting the tire on was not so difficult. I did not even need the tire lever. However, getting it to seal was much more labor intensive. I think the mistake I made was that I did not tighten the valve enough. I was afraid if I tightened the screw too much, I might damage this flimsy plastic of the wheel. Now I want to put the tire on the rear wheel. First, I will install the tubeless valve. So I have already learned that I should tighten this tubeless valve quite a bit. I hope I don't damage anything. Now I will put the tire on the rear wheel. So again, without tire lever. Maybe it will also work without soapy water, I don't know. Now comes the exciting moment. I will open the valve of the tire booster and let's see what happens. Not yet get the seal. Now it has a seal. Yeah, now I have a seal. I have 5 bar. I have prepared the sealant and I'll put it in. So, no big mess. Seems like I'm getting experienced. I've pumped it up to maximum pressure. No mess at all. It seems like I'm becoming an experienced tubeless mounter. Or maybe the wheels are just getting better regarding the tubeless setup. When I tried to mount the cassette, I had an unpleasant surprise. I noticed that my Bertzmann cassette tool did not fit. I had used this cassette tools to mount cassettes on many other wheels, never had a problem with this. Just to this stupid zip hub, it does not fit. The nice thing about this cassette tool was that I would this would fit on my torque wrench. So I could tighten this lock ring to exactly 40 Newton meters, as it says I should. Therefore I ordered another cassette tool. I ordered this Park tool FR5.2G, hoping that this would fit. The bad thing about it is it does not fit on my torque wrench. So I somehow have to guess how much 40 Newton meter would be. At the same time, when I bought this new cassette tool, I also bought a Tubolito inner tube with a 60mm valve, which should fit to this wheel. This Tubolito tube is very small, very lightweight. It will be not be too bothersome to take it with me on rides at a spare emergency inner tube. However, I hope I will never need it. I hope I will never get a puncture, or if I get a puncture, then it will seal itself with a sealant. Now this spark tool, cassette tool, fits for some reason. And now I need to tighten the screw, or this lock screw, to 40 Newton meter. I think this is 40 Newton meter. The smart thing to do would be to use the Altegra discs for my existing wheel set. However, I decided to buy these Dura Ace discs because of the nice black color. I am aware that getting a carbon wheel set is for somebody like me vanity, and getting for this Dura Ace discs because of the black color is probably vanity squared. The zip wheels came with zip lock rings. I'm sure they would look very good because they are black, but it seems like there's a special tool needed to tighten this lock ring, and I don't have this tool. Therefore, I have to use these Dura Ace lock rings. On this side of the wheel, I'm in luck. My Wurzmann cassette tool fits, so I can use the torque wrench to tighten the lock ring to 40 Newton meter. This is how the rear wheel looks like with the Altegra cassette and the Dura Ace disc. Now I have mounted the disc also on the front wheel. And the weight of this wheel set, including the Schwalbe Pro 1 tires with sealant, the Altegra cassette, and the Dura Ace discs, seems to be 2750 grams. I bought my Rose Endurance bike with these DT Swiss P1750 wheels. These wheels are specially made for Rose. They are similar to the P1800 wheels. I think they are very good, sturdy alloy wheels. The spokes and hubs have a very good quality, and I'm sure they are much better than the spokes and the hubs of the Zip 303S wheels. I bought the bike with the Schwalbe Pro 1 tires, which are now on the Zip 303S wheels. For training, I've been using now these 32mm Goodyear Eagle All-Season tires. They are bigger, more robust, and for training I don't mind the weight. And the weight of this wheel set is really not that bad. It is 3150 grams, including the DT Swiss P1750 wheels, the Shimano 101 cassette, the Altegra discs, and the Goodyear Eagle All-Season tires. This is how my bike looks like with the Zip 303S wheel set and the Dura Ace discs. I think it looks fast, and it would be very embarrassing if I come into a transition zone last with this bike. Something odd I noticed was that my 28mm Schwalbe Pro 1 tires are a little bit wider than 31mm on these wheels. So I'm lucky that my frame has enough clearance for this. I mentioned before that to me the hubs and spokes of the DT Swiss wheels look better than the hubs and spokes of these Zip wheels. However, that's my very subjective impression. I might be wrong.
I noticed some weird surface pattern on these wheels. I was worried that this might be a problem. However, it appears to be normal. I made a short video about this and I was recommended to contact Lucia Technique, the authority on carbon bikes stuff. And he was so kind to answer me and he said it's not good, but it's probably within tolerance, so I do not worry about this. I already went on a few rides with this wheel set and it really feels faster than my DT Swiss wheel set. Maybe this is due to the reduced rotational weight. In one of the last GCN videos we learned that the rotational weight really does not make much difference. However, it accelerates faster and that really feels. I know the zip wheels with the 28mm Schwalbe Pro One tires are about 400 grams heavier than the DT Swiss wheels with the 32mm Goodyear tires. However, compared to my total system weight, this is really negligible. So the weight of myself in this fancy Decathlon Van Rysel speed suit with the Giro Vanquish helmet and the Shimano RC8 road shoes and the complete bike would be 71.3 kilograms. So 400 grams would be about 0.5%, and I don't think this will make a big difference. I was curious if I would see any real world differences between my DT Swiss wheels with the 32mm Goodyear tires and the Zip 303S wheels with the 28mm Schwalbe Pro One tires. The best way to do such a comparison would be to do rides at exactly the same conditions in parallel universes. Unfortunately, I do not have contact to parallel universes. I also do not have a power meter. So I did just some very basic and not very scientific tests by riding up a hill and riding a straight piece of country road, just measuring my speed and my heart rate. The ride up the hill was 4.3 kilometers long with 280 meters elevation gain. The course is called the Kalkofensteige. It is very scenic and it is very popular among mountain bikers and road cyclists in our area. With the DT Swiss wheels, I had an average speed of 13.0 km per hour. And with the Zip wheels, I had an average speed of 14.2 km per hour at roughly the same heart rate of 150 beats per minute. So the Zip wheels were a little faster. This might be due to the slightly lower weight or due to the reduced rolling resistance of the Schwalbe tires. However, I do not really believe that there would be a real difference between the wheels when riding up a hill. I would attribute the higher speed mainly to the relatively strong tailwind I had when I was riding the Zip wheels. On this course, there is a so-called stop-o-mat, where it is possible to stem the starting time and the finishing time of the uphill ride on a card, submitting the card and entering a ranking. But I need a lot more training before I can enter this ranking with dignity. Or maybe I need even more expensive wheels, or maybe I need to buy a bike at Hardy's bike shop. It seems good riders have an average speed of more than 17 km per hour, and I am still far from that, even with strong tailwind. Then I did a test on a 5.6 km straight piece of country road with a slight decline of 64 meters. I reach a relatively high speed when riding in the aero bars, which sometimes can be a bit scary because motorists often pass me very closely at very high speed. Here I had an average speed of 40.8 km per hour with the DT Swiss wheels, and with the Zip wheels I had an average speed of 41.6 km per hour at roughly the same heart rate. So with the Zip wheels and the 28mm tires, I was significantly faster. In this case, I had a relatively strong headwind when riding the Zip wheels, so I'm pretty sure that in this case the advantage of the Zip wheels with the Schwalbe tires is real and significant. So my conclusion would be that in a situation where aerodynamics is important, the Zip wheels with the 28mm Schwalbe Pro One tires will be noticeably faster than the DT Swiss wheels with the 32mm Goodyear all-season tires. Though of course I do not know how much of the difference is due to the tires and how much is due to the wheels. But I would assume that the wheels do make some difference in such a situation.
Whether this difference is worth paying more than 1000 euro, that is very questionable. Of course, for me, the answer is clearly yes, it is worth it. In a triathlon, it will probably make a huge difference for me. Maybe instead of rank 1500, I will reach rank 1495 when riding the zip wheels.